The Smash series has somewhat of a reputation for being unbalanced. 64 started off alright, but with such a long developed metagame, dominant characters were bound to arise. Melee is fairly balanced among a group of the best characters in the game, but pretty much everyone else is borderline useless in today's meta. Brawl was an interesting case. Like Melee, it had a slew of useless characters, but then a bunch of other fighters with polarizing matchups. They might do well against some of the better characters in the game, but then have one randomly unwinnable matchup because of an infinite combo setup that worked exclusively on them. And at the top were Meta Knight and Ice Climbers, who didn't really lose to anyone, and the majority of top players would gravitate towards these two. As the first Smash game with patches and DLC, Smash 4's balance went all over the place. Upon its initial release on 3DS, some characters were extremely broken. Rosalina had a back throw almost as strong as Ness's, Sheik actually had tons of kill power, and there was of course Diddy Kong with the infamous hoo-ha combo. All three of these characters were toned down a bit in patches, and Smash 4 was actually quite balanced for a while, albeit with a boatload of jank. About halfway through the game's lifespan, though, Cloud released, shortly followed by Bayonetta. These characters were almost designed to be pay to win, and the two began to dominate Smash 4's meta for the remainder of its lifespan. Bayonetta in particular joined Brawl Meta Knight as one of the most broken characters in Smash history. When Smash Ultimate launched, many of us expected this trend to continue. Who was the broken SS tier character now? Pikachu? Palutena? Peach? But in reality, no single character has ever been unanimously agreed upon as the best in Ultimate. Even well over a year into the game's lifespan with multiple DLC fighters, there's still no clear best. And the cast is fairly balanced in general too. As with every Smash game, there are top tiers, high tiers, mid tiers, and low tiers, but for the first time, it feels like the cast is pretty top heavy. There are really a lot of characters that can perform well in competitive Ultimate. And there are still plenty who cannot. And that's what this new video series is about. In these videos, we'll be highlighting some of the weakest characters in Smash Ultimate and discussing potential ways that they could be improved to become more relevant and viable. We've also been reaching out to you for ideas and opinions on this subject, so make sure to subscribe and keep an eye out for our question posts. This video will focus on Little Mac, a character most commonly considered as the worst in the game. But first, for our question of the day, which character would you like to see buffed in Smash Ultimate? Let us know in the comments and stay tuned to learn more about fixing Little Mac. Hey guys, Bonk here, and if you'd like to learn to play as Little Mac or any character, you can check out our detailed guides for every fighter on ProGuides.com. That's not all, we've also got live classes that let you play with pros and courses taught by top players like MKLeo. You can even get yourself a personal coach with our InstaPro feature, so log on to ProGuides.com today. Ever since his initial release trailer in Smash 4, Little Mac's fundamental design has received much criticism among competitive players. If you didn't know, the idea behind Mac is that he's an overpowered character on the ground, but underpowered in the air. For what it is, this design is well executed in Little Mac's character. He has incredible ground movement, super fast frame data on his jab and tilts, and super armor on his smash attacks, which pack a punch, literally. And then, his aerial attacks are borderline useless, his aerial acceleration is terrible, and his recovery travels basically nowhere. Objectively, this design is balanced. But through the scope of competitive play, it's quite the opposite. For one thing, aerial gameplay is an essential part of Smash. Having low end lag, combo potential, kill potential, and the ability to move while attacking, aerials are most likely the best moves in Smash. If you play any character besides Little Mac, you'd probably rather lose your ground moves than your aerials. Because of his design, Mac misses out on a huge part of fundamental Smash gameplay, which is the air game. On a deeper level, Mac's detriments present an even bigger issue, however. At high competitive levels, it's really hard to compensate for weaknesses with strengths. When you look at some of the lower tier characters like Mac, Ganondorf, Incineroar, and the like, they all have some really good attributes, but they also have horrible weaknesses. In competitive play, weaknesses are more exploitable than strengths are punishable. And Little Mac could not be a more perfect example of this. When you look at the best characters in the game, they do have amazing strengths, but they also lack any significant weaknesses, and this is really important. In Mac's case, it really doesn't matter how good he is on the ground, because it only takes one win of neutral to put him in a horrible disadvantage state where he'll likely take tons of damage or even lose a stock. You might even argue that Mac doesn't actually have the best ground moves in the game either, but let's take a look at some potential fixes, starting with some of your ideas. Viewer, oh boy, that derpy snake had a few ideas to share. They proposed improving Mac's combo game, as well as improving the aspects that already make him strong, such as reducing lag on side B, increasing hit stun on down tilt, and increasing knockback on up B. These would all be a big help for little Mac. Shaving some lag off of side B would make this move safer to use as a hard callout in neutral, but also help Mac's recovery a lot. With less lag, it would be harder to punish the side B off stage, and he could also jump or up B out of it without losing as much height. Increasing down tilt hit stun would vastly improve Mac's combo and kill potential. Down tilt is already a combo starter, but it's fairly inconsistent. A buff like this will make it easier for Mac to rack up early percent damage and also kill confirm into moves like side B, up smash, and up B. This would be nicely complemented by the proposed knockback and hitbox buffs to Mac's up special, making it a more reliable kill confirm and out of shield option. As great as this all would be for Mac, these are all buffs, and our goal is to fix the character. It's pretty interesting to take note of the differences. Changes like the idea we just went over are quite similar to the patch changes we actually get from Nintendo, which clearly aim to improve the character without changing their design. We'd like to focus on ways to achieve exactly that, to keep a character who they are and make them better. In Mac's case, however, it's his very core design that results in his competitive failing, so it'll probably take more than just buffs to make him viable. Moving on to the next viewer suggestion,
Hallelujah!
proposes improving Mac's grab game such that he can combo out of down throw and kill with the other throws. The viewer goes on to clarify that this won't take Mac too far, but will get him out of bottom three. And it just might. Mac is pretty good at scaring players into shields, so a throw buff would be useful. As implied, however, this wouldn't change much. Mac is already a character who struggles to catch players who circle camp on platforms, and these buffs would only further encourage that playstyle. Viewer Kung Fu Ducky proposes Little Mac be joined by a character named Roni, like Macaroni, to form an Ice Climbers-esque pair called the Boxer Shorts. Nicely done. We also received many more suggestions that involve buffs such as allowing side B to be used again after being hit, and other miscellaneous buffs similar to the first comment. But then, a viewer by the name of Jammy Man takes a slightly different approach. Jammy proposes to focus on making Little Mac more balanced and less polarizing. He suggests buffing Mac's aerials in general to the point where they are useful but still not fantastic, as well as improving his aerial mobility and recovery. Jammy then proposes a set of nerfs to compensate for these improvements, such as a slightly weaker knockback on KO punch, and a possible armor reduction on Mac's smash attacks. This feels like a good way to start fixing Mac. To hold his own in competitive play, Little Mac needs an aerial game. It's arguably even more of an issue than his recovery in some matchups. His aerials don't have to be amazing, but they can be average. Back air is a safe spacing tool, fair is an anti-air, up air for juggles, nair for breaking combos, and dare for some slightly stronger spikes. In most cases, all these moves really need is less landing lag and a hitbox and knockback augmentation, although fair and bare could stand to be a bit quicker too. These aerials would still not be fantastic because of their lack of range and disjoints. This would be accompanied by an increase to Mac's aerial acceleration, so he has some real control in the air. His drift speed is actually pretty good already, believe it or not. For recovery, the air acceleration would already help a lot, and then they could make some simple changes such as slightly improving the distance on up B and let it snap to ledge, allowing side B to be performed again after being hit, and giving Mac a normal directional air dodge. The idea of nerfing the super armor on Mac's smashes seems like a good way to compensate for these improvements. His smash attacks are already strong enough to win most trades, so he wouldn't be in the worst shape if the armor was removed altogether, or at least replaced with knockback-based armor. Likewise, KO Punch doesn't need to KO quite so early, but it could keep that power if it was made to lose to shields, or perhaps disappear after a time period like Cloud's Limit. These changes would slightly alter Mac's design, but he'd remain a character who performs best on the ground and actually have a fighting chance. Do you agree? Let us know in the comments, and also tell us which character you'd like to see us cover in the series next. Thanks for watching, and we'll catch you in the next one.